everyone, welcome to my channel if you're new here, and welcome back if you're a subscriber. So it's finally love season, and it's a perfect time for you to give your loved one some cute gift. For today's tutorial, I'm gonna show you how to make this car hanger with some cute characters. We have Bunny, Chick, and also our all-time favorite Totoro. And because it's Valentine's season, they also have this tiny heart sling bag which makes them even cuter. Alright, before we start, please remember to hit the subscribe button because it would really help to keep this channel growing so you can get more easy tutorial like this in the future. Then let's get started. In this project, I'm using 5-ply mil cotton yarn, a 3.5mm hook, a scissor, a tapestry needle, a stitch marker, some stuffing, and a pair of safety eyes. We will start with the body, and this pattern applies to all characters. Start with a slip knot, or you can also use the magic ring. Then chain 2. Continue with 6 single crochet in the very first chain. This is our first round. Now we will continue to the second round. Do increase, repeat for 6 times. For increase, we have to make 2 single crochet in the same stitch. In the end, we will have 12 single crochet. And don't forget to put on a stitch marker in the first single crochet. I will continue crocheting, and we will meet at the end of the round. Next, continue to the third round. We will do 1 single crochet and then 1 increase, repeat for 6 times. In the end, we will have 18 single crochet. I will repeat this pattern, and we will meet at the end of the round. Now for the fourth round, we will do 1 single crochet, 1 increase, and another 1 single crochet, repeat for 6 times. In the end, we will have 24 single crochet. I will continue crocheting, and we will meet at the end of the round. And this is how it looks like so far. Now we will continue to the fifth round. For the fifth round, we will do single crochet around. In the end, we will have 24 single crochet. I will continue crocheting, and we will meet at the end of the round. As you can see here, it's starting to look more round. Now we will continue to the sixth round. We will do 3 single crochet and then 1 increase, repeat for 6 times. In the end, we will have 30 single crochet. I will repeat this pattern, and we will meet at the end of the round. Now continue to the next round. Start from round 7 to round 12, we will do single crochet around. So we will have 30 single crochet in each round. will continue crocheting and we will meet at the end of round 12. Now we have finished until round 12 and this is how it looks like. Then we will continue to round 13. We will do 3 single crochet and then 1 decrease repeat for 6 times. In the end, we will have 24 single crochet. For the decrease, we will do invisible decrease. So we will work in front loop only. First, insert the hook into the next loop and go to the next one. Then grab the yarn, pull out the 2 loops, and finish it off just like a regular single crochet. So that's how we make invisible decrease and we will continue crocheting. I will repeat this pattern and we will meet at the end of the round. Now continue to round 14. We will do decrease repeat for 12 times. In the end, we will have 12 single crochet. So we will do invisible decrease around until we have 12 single crochet. I will continue crocheting and we will meet at the end of the round. So this is how it looks like so far. Now we will attach the eyes. We will attach it in between round 6 and 7. Now we will attach the other one with the distance of 5 stitches. This is how it looks like. Now we will start stuffing. I'm using some fiberfill stuffing, but you can also use some yarn scraps. And now we will continue stuffing as much as we need. Once you have satisfied with your stuffing, we will continue to our last round. So for this round, we will do decrease, repeat for 6 times. In the end, we will have 6 single crochet. I will continue crocheting and we will meet at the end of the round. Now we have finished crocheting and we will finish it off. Cut off the yarn but leave a long tail for sewing. Next, grab the tapestry needle and we will sew to close up this tiny loop. Now we will start sewing and I will sew in front loop only. But feel free to use your own favorite sewing method. Now we have done with the body and this is how it looks like. Next we will continue to make the arms. Now for the arms, start with a slip knot or you can also use the magic ring. This pattern also applies to all characters. Then chain 2 and continue with 5 single crochet in the very first chain. And this is our first round. Next, from round 2 to round 3, we will only do single crochet around. So we will have 5 single crochet in each round. I will continue crocheting and we will meet at the end of round 3. And this is how our arm looks like. Now cut off the yarn, leave a long tail for sewing, and we have to make another one. So we will have 2 little arms. For the tiny heart sling bag, start with a slip knot, or you can also use the magic ring. Then chain 2. Continue with 1 single crochet in the very first chain. Next, a half double crochet, 2 double crochet, slip stitch, 2 double crochet, a half double crochet, and slip stitch to the first single crochet. Now finish it off with chain 1, cut off the yarn and fasten off. Next, grab the tapestry needle and a strand of yarn, and we will attach it to the heart. We will attach it in the back side and diagonally, so it will look like a strap for the sling bag. Now we have done with the sling bag, and we will continue to make the swing. For the swing, start with a slip knot. Then chain 11. Next, skip 1 stitch and do 10 single crochet. We have done with the first row, now we will continue to the next row, chain 1, turn our work and do 10 single crochet. So we will repeat this pattern until we reach up to row 4. I will continue crocheting and we will meet at the end of row 4. And this is how it looks like after we crocheting until row 4. Next, we will do single crochet around. Start with 1 single crochet in the same stitch. So we have 2 single crochet in the first corner, and we will do 2 single crochet in every corner. I will continue crocheting and we will meet at the last corner. And this is how it looks like. Now we will finish it off with the invisible fasten off. So cut off the yarn and leave a long tail, then pull out the tail. Next, grab the tapestry needle and insert the needle into the first single crochet. Then go back to the back loop of the stitch where the tail comes out of. And this is how it looks like. Now we will do the strap of the swing. First, insert the hook into the stitch in the middle and then attach the yarn. Then chain 70 or as long as you need. After that, slip stitch into the stitch in the other side. Then finish it off with chain 1, cut off the yarn and leave a long tail for sewing. And we have done with the swing. Now for the bunny's ear, we will start with a slip knot, or you can also use the magic ring. Then chain 2, Continue with 6 single crochet in the very first chain. So this is our first round. Now we will continue to the second round. We will do 1 single crochet and then 1 increase, repeat for 3 times. In the end, we will have 9 single crochet. I will continue crocheting and we will meet at the end of the round. Now we will continue to the next round. From round 3 to round 5, we will do single crochet around. So we will have 9 single crochet in every round. I will continue crocheting and we will meet at the end of round 5. So this is how it looks like after we finish until round 5. Now we will continue to the next round. For round 6, we will do 1 single crochet and then 1 decrease, repeat for 3 times. In the end, we will have 6 single crochet. I will continue crocheting and we will meet at the end of the round. Now we have finished round 6 and we will finish it off. Cut off the yarn, leave a long tail for sewing. Pull out the long tail and grab the tapestry needle. Now we will start sewing and fold slightly at the bottom. We will continue sewing to make it secure and shaped like a bunny's ear. This is how the ear looks like. Do not cut the long tail because we will use it to attach the ear to the body. And now we have to make another one. Now we have the ears and it's time to attach the ears to the body. We will attach by sewing it. I will continue sewing and we will meet after I finish both of the ears. So this is how it looks like after we finish attach the ears. Now it's time to embroider the nose. I'm using a strand of black yarn to make the nose. And now we're done with the nose. Next, we will put some blush on in the ears and cheeks. Next, I will attach the sling bag to the bunny using glue. I will also put a little glue on the strap. Now we have finished our bunny and this is how it looks like. Now for Totoro, we already have the body and the arms. Now we will do the ear. Start with a slip knot or you can also use the magic ring. Then chain 2. Continue with 4 single crochet in the very first chain. This is our first round. Now continue to the second round. We will do one single crochet and then one increase, repeat for 2 times. In the end, we will have 6 single crochet. Continue to the third round. We will do 2 single crochet and then 1 increase, repeat for 2 times. In the end, we will have 8 single crochet. I will repeat this pattern and we will meet at the end of the round. And this is how it looks like so far. Now we will continue to the next round. From round 4 to round 5, we will do single crochet around. So we will have 8 single crochet in each round. I will continue crocheting and we will meet at the end of round 5. This is how it looks like after we finish crocheting until round 5. Now we will continue to round 6. For round 6, we will do decrease, repeat for 4 times. In the end, we will have 4 single crochet. I will repeat this pattern and we will meet at the end of the round. Now we have finished the ear. After that, we have to cut off the yarn, leave a long tail for sewing. This is our ear and we have to make another one, so we will have 2 ears. Next, we will do the eyes using white yarn. Make a slip knot or you can also use the magic ring. Chain 2 and continue with 5 single crochet in the very first chain. Now we have done. Next, cut off the yarn and leave a long tail to do the invisible fasten off. So, grab the tapestry needle and insert the needle into the first single crochet. Then, go back to the back loop of the stitch where the tail comes out of. Next, we will attach the safety eyes into the loop in the middle. And we're done with the eyes. Now we will continue to make the belly. For the belly, start with a slip knot or you can also use the magic ring. Then chain 2, continue with 6 single crochet in the very first chain. So this is the first round, now continue to the second round. We will do increase, repeat for 6 times. In the end, we will have 12 single crochet. I will continue crocheting and we will meet at the end of the round. Now we will continue to the third round. We will do 1 single crochet and then 1 increase, repeat for 6 times. In the end, we will have 18 single crochet. I will repeat this pattern and we will meet at the end of the round. Next, we will continue to the fourth round. For this round, we will do single crochet around. In the end, we will have 18 single crochet. I will continue crocheting and we will meet at the end of the round. And this is how the belly looks like. I have finished it off with the invisible fasten off and leave a long tail for sewing. Next, I will embroider the belly. So to embroider the belly, we will use the same way as making a smile, but this one is a reverse smile. And this is our first reverse smile. Now we have to make 4 more, so in the end we will have 5 reverse smiles. Now I'm going to make the second one. And this is the second one. Now I will finish all this embroidery. So this is how the belly looks like. Now we will assemble all the body parts together. We will start with attaching the eyes. We will attach the eyes in between round 5 and 6. And for the second eye, we will attach it 5 stitches away from the first one. Then we will put some glue to make it secure. Next, we will attach the belly by sewing it. I will continue and we will meet after I finish sewing. Next, we will attach the ears. We will also attach it by sewing it. I will continue and we will meet after I finish sewing both of the ears. So I have finished the totoro, I have attached the ears, and this little leaf has the same pattern as the little heart. And I have also embroidered the face. I made 2 whiskers in the right and left sides, and also I made a little nose. For the cheek, we already have the body, the arms, and also the heart sling back. And for the eyes, we attach it in between round 6 and 7, just like the bunny. Now we will continue do the little bow for the cheek. For the bow, start with a slip knot, or you can also use the magic ring. Then chain 4. After that, do 1 double crochet in the very first chain. Then chain 3. Next, slip stitch to the very first chain. Now again, chain 3. 1 double crochet. Chain 3. And slip stitch. Now we will finish it off with chain 1, cut off the yarn and leave a long tail. Next, we will wrap around the tail in the middle of the bow for a few times. Once you have satisfied, we will make a knot in the behind to make it secure. And we have finished the bow. Now we have completed all the cheek parts, and it's time to assemble everything together. I will start with embroider the muff using the orange yarn. So this is the first layer, and we will do it one more time. So this is how we embroider the muff. Now we will put some blush on to make the cheek looks cuter. Next, we will attach the bow on top of the head by sewing it. So I will continue, and we will meet after I finish sewing. So this is how the cheek looks like after we finish attaching the bow and sling back. Now I'm gonna show you how to attach the doll to the swing. First, we will put the swing in the bottom of the bunny. Next, I will put some pins to keep the swing staying in its place while we swing it. Next, we will start sewing, and we will sew all around the swing. So I will continue, and we will meet after I finish sewing. So this is how it looks like after we attach the swing. Now we will continue to attach the arms. We will attach the arms on top of the swing strap. This will make it look like the bunny is holding on to the swing. Now we will start sewing. So I will continue, and we will meet after I finish sewing both of the arms. So that's all for today's tutorial. I hope you guys enjoy this video, and if you do, please don't forget to hit the thumbs up and subscribe buttons. Also, follow me on Instagram and TikTok, and feel free to tag me there if you make this project. Thanks for watching, and have a lovely day, everyone.